Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We thank God for bringing us here this morning, and we pray that the Lord that has brought us here will bless us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let us bow our head as we pray unto the Lord. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your faithfulness. We thank you for how you have counted us worthy to be among the living soul today. Father, may your name be exalted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
A songwriter says, when I come into your presence, I'm so happy. When I'm come to your presence, I'm so glad. In your presence, there's anointing, and the Spirit of the Lord is moving. In your presence, anointing breaks the yoke. As we have come this morning to learn at your feet, Father, we pray, O Lord, you will minister to our soul in Jesus' name.
Amen.
As for many that are supposed to be here, they are not here, we pray for the Spirit of the living God to bring them down in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Take absolute control of today's service in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We thank God for bringing us here this morning. And we pray that the Lord that has brought us here, we bless us in Jesus' name. And we all have our plan of study with us, and we are going to go through the plan of study together. And, you know, like this Holy Scripture teaching, you know, is a teaching. You know, we just want us to know more about the Word of God. So it's a teaching. We are teaching you things, deep things, that's about the Word of God. And I pray that as we pay attention, as we listen attentively, the Lord Almighty will bless us, and we'll be able to know the Word of God more than ever before. And we also will be able to teach other people about the Word of God.
Amen.
The Lord will bless us as we listen to His Word in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
This morning, the topic is, everything God made was very good. Everything God made was very good. Our text, our memory verse, like the pastor said, that we're going to learn it, and we have this plan of study with us. We are taking it home. So during the week, we make sure we memorize it, and we'll be able to say it next week by the grace of God, if Jesus tarries. And the Lord will bless us in Jesus' name. As we memorize the Word of God, we be the doer of the Word, we will be justified at the end of the day in Jesus' name. So our memory verse is taken from the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 7, and we are going to read verse 29. Somebody is smiling. You want to memorize it for us?
No, it's
right here. Okay. All right. We are going to count three, and we're going to read it together. After the count of three, one, two, three, go. Lo, this only have I found, that God had made man upright, but they have sought out many inventions. Praise the Lord. It says, lo, this only have I found, that God had made man upright, but they have sought out many inventions. Our text is taken from the book of Genesis. Genesis chapter 1 from the beginning. Genesis chapter 1, and we are going to read from verses 29 to 31. Genesis chapter 1, verses 29 to 31. And God said, behold, I have given you every herb bearing seed, which is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree, in the which is the fruit of a tree yielding seed. To you it shall be for meat, and to every beast of the earth, and to every fowl of the air, and to everything that creepeth upon the earth, wherein there is life. I have given every green herb for meat, and it was so. Verse 31. And God saw everything that he had made, and behold, it was very good. And the evening and the morning were the sixth day. Praise the Lord. And we're going to open to the book of 1 Timothy chapter 4. 1 Timothy chapter 4. And we are going to read verses 4. It says, 1 Timothy chapter 4, verses 4. For every creature of God is good, and nothing to be refused, if it be received with thanksgiving. Praise the Lord. Amen. We see that from our previous study of this Holy Scripture teaching, HST, Holy Scripture teaching, we learned that God created man and all things, and that it was not through evolution or Big Bang like the scientists said, but God is the creator of all things. In today's HST, after the creation of all things, God determined their food, as we can see in our text. And God saw everything that he had made, and behold, it was very good. Before now, in the stages of creation, after the completion of one section, and the Bible we say, and God saw that it was good. Each time God made his creation, when God made the light, made the darkness, Lord sees that those things were good. Let's open our Bible to the book of same Genesis. I know we're going to dwell much on the book of Genesis because we are talking about the creation of God. I mean, the things that God created. Genesis chapter 1, let's see verse 4. And God saw the light, and it was good. And God divided the light from the darkness. But after the creation of man and food assigned to man, to every beast of the earth, and to every fowl of the air, and to everything that creepeth upon the earth, wherein there was life. Then the Bible says, and God saw everything that it was he made, and behold, it was very good. So we are just teaching us, of course we know that God is the creator of all things, and I want us to be able to teach our children. And that's why we are, you know, going deep into the from the book of Genesis. And we know that God created everything. Sometimes, you know, the children will ask you, how did God, you know, a lot of questions we may not be able to answer, but we just believe that God is our creator and God created everything. We are going to consider this topic under three subtopics. The first part is going to be God made man upright. The second part will be invention of good things. Invention of those things. And the third part will be invention of evil things. Chapter 1, verse 30 says, and God saw everything that he had made, and behold, it was very good, including you and I. God, when God created Adam, it was very good, not until the fall of Adam and Eve. And God saw everything that he had made, and behold, it was very good, including you and I. For truly, God had made man upright, but they have sought out many inventions, as we have seen from our memory verse. When God created man, he created man in his own image and in his likeness. So you tell yourself, you are the image of God. You look like God. And that is why you have to act like God, behave like God. What will Jesus do at any situation of our life? Because we need to remember that we are created in the likeness of God. What does it mean? It means holy as God is holy. Let's open our Bible to the book of Psalm 86. Psalm 86, verse 2. You are created in the image of God. Preserve my soul, for I am holy. O thou my God, save thy servant that trusted in thee. So, the Bible says, be ye holy, for I am holy. So God expects us to be holy. God made us to be holy. And I pray that the Lord Almighty will help us and give us the grace to be holy and live our life according to his will in Jesus' name. Do not tell lies, for God do not tell lies. Numbers, let's open our Bible to the book of Numbers chapter 23, verse 19. Numbers chapter 23, verse 19. He says, God is not a man that he should lie, neither the son of man that he should repent. And he said, and shall he not made it? Or had he spoken, and shall he not make it good? That is the question. God is not a liar. If God has promised to do something, God will do it. God is not a liar. And the liars, we have their part in hell. Both white lie, small lie, big lie, the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Okay. Then we also see, like God, in Hebrews chapter 2. Hebrews chapter 2, verse 11. Let's see. For both he that sanctified and they who are sanctified, all are of one, for which cause he is not ashamed to be called them brethren. So we are like God, we are like Christ. So we are one in God, especially if you are giving your life to him. They have the divine nature. This is, you know, very important for us to look at 2 Peter chapter 1. Let's open our Bible to the book of 2 Peter chapter 1. Verse 3. He says, according as his divine power had given unto us all things that pertain to unto life and godliness through the knowledge of him that had called us to his glory and virtue. Wherefore are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by this ye might be partaker of his divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in this world through the lost. So the Lord is telling us, reminding us, that we have to be able to partake from his divine nature, living a life of godliness. We also see that, you see from our outline, the next one said D, it's supposed to be E. Walk as Christ walked. You know, like we said, that this is a teaching, so we'll be opening more of the Bible so that we can see it ourselves. 1 John chapter 2. 1 John chapter 2, and we are going to read verse 6. 'And turning the city of Sodom and Gomorrah. I'm sorry, I got wrong. He that saith he abideth in him ought himself also to do to to walk even as he walked. How did Jesus walk? How did he walk? And we have to be able to pattern our life according to his steps. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. So we are going to look at the second topic, which is invention of good things. You know, like there's a lot of things in this world that man has made that is beneficiary to the humanity. And that's why let's see some of those things that man made. God gave them the knowledge to be able to make it. And what I discover is that everything that man made, God have the example of it. For instance, like the birds that fly in the air, God gave man, you know, innovation, invention to be able to make an airplane. Airplane, and they make it like a bird. God was the one that first created bird before the God gave them wisdom to be able to create the aircraft that flies in the air just like bird. Look at the winter time, and God gave men wisdom to be able to create refrigerators. It's cold, and now we're able to get the refrigerator. You know, everything that you can think of, you will see that at one point or the other, the Lord, there is something they said, maybe clone. They are trying to make human being. But that human being will live for certain, I mean, they will clone somebody. Like, you know, the person will be like exactly like the other person to the extent that you can miss them. Like, oh, you will think this is the person. And the person will be talking. And that person will live for some certain, I don't know whether it's a month or... And then eventually the person will die, and that's the end of the thing. So they have really, you know, made, and that one, I'm not saying maybe that one is good, or no, I take that back. But a lot of things that they have made in this world, let's see more, some of those things. Like we made mention before that man have sought out many inventions, as we have seen in the book of Ecclesiastes. But we need to know that not all inventions are evil. That is why Romans chapter 1 verse 30 spoke about the evil inventors of evil things. Those ones are sinful things for you to invent evil things. So, but there are some inventions that are good, and those ones that are good, the Christian can utilize that. But those evil inventions, we have to stay away from those. And the Lord Almighty will help us in Jesus' name. Amen. Like we see, God, good inventions are those inventions that do not lure us away from Christ or weaken our relationship with God. When used in an appropriate manner, this includes the following, like we have seen, you know, we talk about the money that solved the problem of trade by barter. We can see that in the book of Matthew chapter 17 verse 27. 1 Timothy chapter 6 verse 10. We talk of cars, we talk of airplanes, we talk of bike, we talk of train, and so many things. As long as we did not allow it to be our God. Do you know that even like this car, do you know that some people, when they have a car, they be like, if I had that somebody wrote that, see my God, that's the plate number on the car. You understand? Some people make that car, even though it's a good thing, but they make it to be their God. Oh, nobody can sit in it. They can't even give somebody a ride. They can, you know, they take that car like God. Like one time that we have that is not given to us. So we should not, even though it's a good invention, when you have a car, you'll be able to move from one place to the other. You come to church early, you know, and so on. But we should not make it to be our God. And that makes it to be a problem. This cell phone, we use it for communication. But do you know that some people, when they are coming to church, if they forget their cell phone, and they are almost at the church, they will turn back to go and get the cell phone. To me, I did not see reason for that. So some people, instead of the time they're supposed to use to read their Bible, they are on the phone. Some people like this, they are so glued to the phone that the phone cannot be far away from them. If they don't have a phone, it's like something is missing in their life. You should not take it like that. It's good for us to use it for communication, but at the same time, we should not make it to be like a god. We cannot do without it. So I pray that the Lord Almighty will help us. All these things God gave them, look at the computers. Inside the computer, internet, some people go in there to go and watch bad movie. And a lot of time you can go to internet, you search for job, you search for information, you are going to somewhere you don't know, you a lot of advantage. But as Christian, we are encouraged to utilize it appropriately. And I pray that the Lord Almighty will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And so many things that, you know, God has given somebody idea to be able to invent, which facilitate, you know, like the cell phone, facilitates communication and all that. What about houses? Look at people build houses. You know, it's very good. And those things, we have comfort in them. If used in an appropriate manner, then there is no problem. We see that, as we have seen, we know we have a lot of inventions, but we are enjoying with us as Christians that we should not set them as our God. We should not put our trust in them. And the Lord Almighty will bless us in Jesus' name. Okay, what about the evil inventions? Those things that are bad. People invent things, a lot of things that are bad. Let's see. Let's open to the book of Romans, actually, Romans chapter 1. Romans chapter 1, and we are going to read verse 30. Verse 30. So we talk about, you know, talk about the evil things people do. It talks about, if you read from like 20 verse 27, if you back up a little bit, you see about the sinful thing that people are doing. But the most important one we wanted to do, they talk about backsliders. They talk about haters of God, despiteful. They talk about proud, people that are proud. They talk about boasters. They talk about inventors of evil things. They talk about disobedient to parents. So the point we are making there is the inventors of evil things. So what are the evil things that we know for sure that, you know, Christians should not even go there? Okay, we see that. Let's open to the book of Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 42. Isaiah chapter 42. And we're going to read verse 6. And the Lord hath called thee in righteousness, and we hold thy hands, and we keep thee, and give thee for a covenant of the people, for a light of the Gentiles, to open the blind eyes, to bring out the prisoner from the prison, and them that sit in darkness out of the prison house. I am the Lord, that is my name, and my glory will I not give to another, neither my praise to graven image. So we should know that God will not share his glory with anybody. Like maybe some ministers that, you know, God has really blessed. You know, some people, you know, they will even say that whatever the pastor say, they don't compare it what the Bible will say. They have really so much make the pastor to be God. So even if the pastor is preaching and is not in conjunction with the word of God, it's as long as it's the GO. No, no, no. Anybody that is telling you something, you have to compare it with the word of God. If it does not align with the word of God, no matter who the person is, it's not going to be accepted by God. And God will not share his glory with anybody. Immoral inventions. immoral inventors. Like, you know, we talk about these people now, Gale, they want Gale to be, you know, now they want man to man, women to men. Some people started it. And now, especially here, they make it like a law. That is not a good thing, and we should not partake in it. We see that there's a lot of things. Let's see. Let's open our Bible to the book of Genesis, chapter 40, verse 22, and to Genesis chapter 40. And it came to pass the third day, which was Pharaoh's birthday, that he made a fix unto all his servants, and he lifted up the head of the chief butler and of the chief baker among his servants, and he restored the chief butler unto his butlership again. And he gave the cup into Pharaoh's hand. But he hanged the chief baker as Joseph had interpreted to them. Do we remember the story of the servant of Pharaoh that were in the prison with Joseph? And Pharaoh, the king, was having a birthday party on that day. And what happened? They had to hang somebody because of celebration of birthday party. So, you know, we don't encourage us to be, you know, doing all this extravagant birthday party. And we always say that, well, Jesus Christ did not do birthday, so what's the point? Some people waste money. That money we're going to waste on party, we can save it for the child college. And then that will be more beneficial to the child than us wasting the money for an unnecessary party. We also see that, you know, some places they make woman sacrifice, and some childhood marriage. 7-year-old, they sell the child, a female child, to go and marry because they want to collect money from the person that wants, you know, all those things. Sacrifice woman, human being. In some part of the world, they still do sacrifice, and they use human being for the sacrifice. And Jesus Christ has come to this world to sacrifice. Jesus Christ has paid it all. And if you know of anything, even some people, even right from here, they want to do one sacrifice in their village. They say, I'm not part of it, all, but you can send money. If you send money to them, you are part of it. So that is why we should not send our money to all those kind of things. Because, you know, if they are not godly, and you'll be like, because of the respect you have for them, you don't want them to feel bad. So you say, let me just send my money. At least I'm not the one doing it. No, you are part of it. So don't join them. Don't send your money to them to do any sacrifice. Invention of abominable religious orgies. Like we can see in the book of Numbers chapter 25 verse 1 to 3. Invention of debasing cruelty. Judges. Chapter 19. Let's look at that one. Judges chapter 19, verses 22 to 26. Judges chapter 19. Let's see. Now, as they were making their hearts merry, behold, the men of the city, certain son of Belial, beset the house round about, and beat at the door, and spake to the master of the house, an old man, saying, bring forth the man that came into thy house, that we may know him. And the man, the master of the house, went out unto them and said unto them, nay, my brethren, nay, I pray you, do not so wickedly, seeing that this man is come into my house. Do not this fully. Behold, here is my daughters, a maiden, my daughter, a maiden, and his concubine. And his concubine. Then I will bring out now and humble ye them, and do with them that seemeth good unto you. But unto this man, do not so while a thing. But the men would not hearken to him. So the man took his concubine and brought her daughter, and brought her forth unto them. And they knew her, and praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And all the night until the morning, and when the day began to spring, they let her go. Then came the woman in the dawning of the day, and fell down at the door of the man's house, where our Lord was, till it was light. And our Lord rose up in the morning, and opened the doors of the house, and went out to go his way. And behold, the woman, his concubine, was falling down at the door of the house, and her hand were upon the threshold. Praise the Lord. So we see that these people, they were trying to rape the visitor. And that was not a good thing. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. We see that, let's also open to invasion of makeups and even fashion. Second Kings chapter 9, verse 22 and verse 30. Zephaniah chapter 1 verse 8. Zephaniah, going towards the end of New Testament and Old Testament, we see Habakkuk towards the end of New Testament. Habakkuk and Zephaniah, chapter 1 verse 8. He said, and it shall come to pass in that day of the Lord's sacrifice, that I will punish the princes and the king's children and all such as are clothed with strange apparel, strange clothing, the clothing that are not glorifying to God. The Lord said he's going to punish, and we don't want to receive that such punishment from the Lord. And the Lord expects us to turn away from that. Invention of degrading shows of the theater and ungodly movie that include these Disney movies for kids. Now they said they have now included gay marriage into their shows. So, and those are not the things that we should allow our children to be watching. If you want to educate them on that, we have to educate them ourselves so that we'll be able to tell them the right thing. But if we allow them to be watching those shows, and those one will be telling them that those things are good, then we put them in the place of parents. So we are pleading with us that we should not allow our children to watch all those things, because the more they watch it, it will be building some kind of interest in them. But as parents, we have to teach them. This is a no-no. You know, tattoo. You know, people now, they use tattoo all over their body. Everybody thinks that's what is reigning now. And God is against it. And I pray that the Lord Almighty will help us in Jesus' name. So we have a lot of things that are evil inventors. I pray that the Spirit of the Lord will be leading us. Some that we did not mention now, as it comes to our mind or comes our way, the Lord will give us the grace to stand and stand out for him in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Let us close our eyes as we pray unto the Lord. Let us commit ourselves unto God's hand. God has made everything beautiful, but man has sought out many inventions. Let us pray that the Lord Almighty will help us. that the inventions that we are going to partake in, we will not partake in the evil inventions. Because we know that if we partake in the evil inventions, then we are enemy of God. And of course, somebody that is enemy of God cannot go to heaven. The Lord Almighty will help us in Jesus' name. Father, we worship you. We thank you for this morning, for this teaching. We pray that what we have learned this morning, it will remain permanent in our life and be doer of his word in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, because you have answered. As we continue, Father, continue with us. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen.